Hey there, everybody! Miss Mendoza here again for your next grade 3 second step lesson. Now, before we get started with today's lesson, let's review a little bit of what we learned last time. So last time, you guys learned about noticing similarities and accepting other people's differences. Now, when you are able to accept other people's differences, this is a way to show respect. And then when you're able to understand other people's perspectives or understand their feelings, this is an example of being or having empathy. And so what I want you guys to always remember is that being respectful and having empathy are two great skills to help you get along better with other people. All right, so now that we've had our quick little review, let's go ahead and get started with our lesson for today. I have a fun and quick activity for us that we're going to do today. We've done something like this before, but today it's going to be a little different. So for this activity, I'm going to need you to really focus your attention and listen in order to figure out which Disney song is being played. So we did this before where you had to figure out what sound is being made. Now it's something a little more specific. So I'm going to have a video and you're going to hear a song. You're not going to see any pictures, no hints. You just have to focus your attention and really listen to figure out either what is the song that's being played or from what movie is the song from. All right, let's get started.
You've got a friend in me. You've got a friend in me. When the road
looks to be concealed, don't feel, don't let them know. Well, now they know. Let it go, let it go. Can't hold it.
That you travel on, there's one day here and the next day gone. Sometimes you bend, sometimes you stand, sometimes you turn your back to the wind. There's a world outside every darkened door, where blues won't haunt you anymore. For the...
Hakuna Matata, what a wonderful phrase. Hakuna Matata, ain't no passing praise.
Today, you'll practice focusing attention and listening to others so that this can help you have empathy for them. Then, you're going to learn how to decide how you can show your concern for other people. So, today we are focusing on two new students. Their names are Cody and Raj. Now, Cody came to school on crutches today. He's telling Raj how he feels about missing kickball game at recess. So just looking at Cody, think about how he feels about missing the kickball game. Do you think he feels happy? Or do you think he feels kind of sad? Well, if you're thinking he's feeling kind of sad, then you're correct. He is feeling sad. But just by looking at him, how can we tell that he is feeling sad or that he's not feeling very good? What are the clues that you see that are telling us that? Well, if you said that you can tell by his body language, that is a great example. We can see that his shoulders are shrugged down, and people kind of do that sometimes when they're not feeling good. Maybe they're really sad or just they don't feel very good. So that is one way to figure out how Cody is feeling. For now, I want you guys to think about what skills for learning are helping Raj listen to Cody as he's speaking. Well, if you're thinking one skill is focusing attention, great job, because that is one skill he's using. What's another one? Well, if you guys are thinking he is listening, that is also another skill that he's using to listen and pay attention to Cody. Now, Raj is focusing on Cody and listening carefully to what he's saying. He asks Cody questions to find out more information. And so, by Raj not only listening to Cody, but also asking more questions is a great way to show that he cares about what Cody is saying and what Cody is feeling. Now up next to me on the screen, I have our empathy poster again. And I had this poster up because Raj is demonstrating some of the skills on the poster. So as Raj listens to Cody, he notices Cody's facial expression and he notices Cody's body language. And he realizes that these are clues that are helping him to understand how Cody is feeling. Raj can also understand Cody's point of view since they've been playing kickball at recess for weeks. And so Raj is really able to understand how Cody is feeling. This is called having empathy, which is why I have the poster up with me. So I want you guys to remember that focusing attention and listening to Cody is what's helping Raj to have empathy. He wants to do something to show his concern now that he knows what Cody is feeling. Now I want you to pretend that you're Raj, and I want you to think about if you were Raj, what could you do or what could you say to Cody to show that you are concerned for him? I'll put back up Mr. Timer to give you guys a little bit of time to think about this. All right, so I'm sure you guys have thought of plenty of different things you can do or say to show Cody that you're concerned for him. Some potential answers you guys may have thought of was you can say really kind things to Cody, like, you know, don't worry, you'll recover soon, just take care of yourself and then you can play with us again. You can even invite him to come and watch you guys play kickball. He can even help be like the referee, you know, and still kind of be a part of the game. Maybe even some other ideas is Raj can offer to stay inside with Cody and hang out with him. That way, Cody isn't the only one who's not playing in kickball. So caring about others and how they feel and showing concern for them is called compassion. So compassion is empathy, but in action. So empathy is what you feel, and compassion is how you show that you have empathy, that you understand what somebody is feeling, and that you are concerned for them. So let's pretend that Raj decides, you know what, I'm going to stay inside during recess to be with Cody and to hang out with Cody. How do you think Cody feels about Raj staying inside with him? Do you think he's feeling really happy about that and excited? Or do you think it's something that he's really sad about? Well, we're going to say that Cody actually is feeling pretty happy because he's not going to be alone. He gets to still be with his friend and he doesn't have to feel left out. Cody thanks Raj when he decides to stay in, and they enjoy playing games together at recess, and Cody has so much fun that he almost forgets that his leg is hurt. So I don't know about you, but I'm going to give Raj a thumbs up because he sounds like a great friend. Focusing on Cody and Raj's situation has really helped us to learn about showing compassion to other people. When we focus our attention and listen, this is going to help us really notice when other people need our care or our concern. When you're able to do this, then you can show your compassion by saying or doing something really nice and something that's going to help these other people feel better. So great job today, guys. We're actually going to wrap up with our empathy song. I'll put that up for you guys. I hope you enjoy it, and I will see you in our next lesson. Bye.
In every situation, your feelings mean so much to you. But you know that you're not alone. There's other folks with feelings too. So when you get together, try to understand how they might feel. 'Cause they might have their own ideas with feelings that are just as real. Oh, empathy means feeling what others feel. You felt it too. Happy, sad, angry, glad. You notice it and you understand. Oh, empathy is feeling what others feel. You felt it too. Happy, sad, angry, glad. You notice it and you understand. That's right. Wonder what's their point of view. The next step is compassion. That's being kind and finding ways to help a friend. That's easy when you understand. Oh, empathy means feeling what others feel. You felt it too. Happy, sad, angry, glad. You notice it and you understand. Oh, empathy is feeling what others feel. You felt it too. Happy, sad, angry, glad. You notice it and you understand. Oh, empathy means feeling what others feel. You felt it too. Happy, sad, angry, glad. You notice it and you understand. Oh, empathy is feeling what others feel. You felt it too. Happy, sad, angry, glad.